Hello, I hope all is well. So, over the past couple weeks, I've been working on a pretty interesting side project whilst playing on my main account. So, I remembered the login details to an extremely old account, one of the first alts I ever made. And so, this is over 4,200 days old, well over 11 years old, which means I made this account as a 13-year-old when I was first starting RuneScape, which is pretty cool, kind of makes this an antique. So I started out this project by getting fishing up, because ultimately what this is going to be is a barbarian fishing trained Gmaul account. So I had this great idea, and before I made it a member and really got started with it, I wanted to at least get level 48 fishing as a free-to-play so that I could really have some time to decide whether or not this was a huge waste of time, which it probably was, but I got the 48 fishing anyway, which is the requirement to start barbarian fishing. One of the first things I did was train up to 800 attack experience on these dummies in Varrok. Now, it's really important not to leave any attack experience on the table, and you cannot do these after level 8 attack. And since you need 101,000 attack experience to get to level 50 attack without training it at all, you definitely want to not leave any on the table. Next, I went ahead and did waterfall quest, which is kind of a standard to get up to 30 attack and 30 strength. After that, I went ahead and tried out Vampire Slayer, which you can safely do because you do not really gain any combat experience while fighting Count Draenor. Unfortunately, I did lose a couple of clips somehow, and that included doing the Fight Arena quest, Grand Tree, and Tree Gnome Village. These are all pretty standard and provide pretty good attack experience. Grand Tree and Tree Gnome Village were really easy, you could just cannon the bosses. However, with the fight arena, you can't set up a cannon in the arena, so I had to use a combination of attacking with a poison plus dagger once and then running behind a safe spot and watching poison kill the targets, or by using recoils and food to kill them that way. I also knocked out the Death Plateau quest for 3,000 attack experience and the ability to use climbing boots. Shadow of the Storm quest was one of the biggest challenges, and I knew I was going to have to take a small amount of HP experience doing this, which was okay because it was going to reward me with 10k attack XP. So I started by shooting Dragon Arrows P++ with the Dark Bow. However, those only poisoned him, I believe, 4. And that was taking a long time, so I hit him once or twice with the Adamant Dagger P++ and poisoned him starting for 6 and was able to just kind of wait it out. You do have to get the last hit with the Dark Light. It's kind of tricky though because his max hit is 11, so you've got to brew your HP up above 11 and then super restore. But ultimately, I did manage to get the kill and get the 10k attack experience, which was extremely helpful because I would not have been able to hit 50 without this quest. These random events are extremely valuable, that is the classroom and the genie. One of the reasons I got my attack trained first was to have the maximum level when I got these events so I could get the most experience possible. However, one of my biggest misestimations of this project was how many of these events I would get. I got about one-third as many as I had hoped, and it took me therefore a lot longer to grind out that last attack level. I next went on to do as many of the easy diaries as I could. These were not very challenging, but a little bit time consuming as I had to get a few skills and do a few quests here and there, and also the act of going around and doing all the diaries took a little bit of time, but for 2,500 experience each, I would not have been able to get 50 attack with 10 HP without this. So I did Falador, Ardone, Varrok, Lumbridge Draenor, and the Wilderness Diaries to start out, and that was 12,500 experience. I was still not quite at my goal, and I pushed a little bit further with the diaries. I may have forgot to mention, but I also did the Kandaren Diary. Then I went on to go do Desert and Karamaja. Unfortunately, Karamaja only gave 1,000 experience instead of 2,500, but at this point, I would take any experience I could get. Unfortunately, I was unable to complete any of the Medium Diaries, as all of them involved either had some quest or skill requirement that I was not able to hit while remaining 10 HP, one prayer, and one defense. I also was not able to complete the Western Provinces diary, as two of the requirements, one is 40 combat to do a game of easy pest control, and another is 30 chompy bird kills, which would definitely have gotten me more HP experience than I wanted. Also, I was unable to complete more Atanya diaries because, first of all, I would have had to have taken the prayer experience for doing Priest in Peril, but I believe I also had to complete In Search of Marik, which would have given me some defense experience. So at this point, I was level 49 attack, about 7k experience from 50, and I was running out of options. I was not getting very many genie and classroom random events, and it appeared my last available path forward was to do the Varrock Museum minigame, hoping to get the antique lamps. But then I was looking through the quest guide list, and I never realized that the, and I can't pronounce this, Tao Bwai Wani Trio quest gives actually 2,500 attack experience. So I went ahead and did this quest. It was nice to be able to get that experience here. But I still was faced with the problem of needing about 4,000 more attack experience. And so I actually went on to, after doing the dig site quest, the Varrock Museum minigame where you get the unclean finds, clean them on the table, and hopefully you get the antique lamp. However, it is only a 1 in 195 chance of getting that. One of the most time-consuming parts of this project was getting the 50 strength through barbarian fishing. So waterfall quest left me at level 30. I still needed to get 20 levels then, and I wish I had kept an accurate count of time spent doing this, but I would estimate it's about half the total time I spent on this project, and this is largely due to the fact that for the most time you're getting 5 or 6 experience per catch, strength experience that is, until you get 45 strength and 70 fishing, at which point you can get up to 7 experience per catch, but that's still extremely slow. I also went ahead to cannon my way to 60 range because part of my rushing technique was going to be a dragon bolt into a Gmauler. So aside from barbarian fishing, this was definitely the next most time-consuming part of this project, and this was getting the 500 XP antique lamps from the Varrock Museum minigame, and I needed a total of 7 of them. Here are my last 3, which took definitely longer than the first 4 to get. So basically what you do is you get the unclean find and you clean it, and it gives you about a 60 or 70% chance of getting an artifact. And then putting the artifact into the crate for a reward gives you a 1 in 195 chance of getting the antique lamp. So this basically completes the project, and here I've put together a little table that shows where all my experience came from. And it goes in order from quest to diaries to the Varrock Museum, and then also kind of the random experience that came from the random events. The first thing that stuck out to me was a very poor estimation in how much experience I would get from random events. I expected double to triple what I ended up getting, and had I got that, I would have not needed to even do the Varrock Museum. And you can see 77k experience came from quests. However, those took less time than the 21k I got off of the diaries, and the diaries took much less time than the 3.5k I got off the Varrock Museum minigame. This is all I have for the building aspect of this project. Hopefully I will be able to get some pretty decent kills with it. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you did find it interesting. I will see you next time.